In this video, we will learn how to install Joomla on our Windows machine for the first time. For installation, you need some kind of installation components or requirement. So here we will see them one by one. Here you can see first we need to go for XAMPP. XAMPP is basically a cross-platform web server package through which we will be getting our MySQL, that would be a database. Apache would be a server, and PHP is what Joomla is written in. So XAMPP provide all these options to us. After going through XAMPP, we will also create a database. After doing all the changes, we will go to joomla.org, download it and install it. While installation, we will make this compatible with the database so that we can add a database to our website, which will add tables to the website also. So here we will see first how we will work upon installation of XAMPP. So let's see how we can easily install XAMPP on our Windows machine for the first time. For installing XAMPP, we need to first download it. So here you can see, go to apachefriends.org/download. Here you can see all the options are visible for XAMPP for Windows. If you want to go for other OS like Linux or Mac, you can easily go through these options. So now we will go to XAMPP for Windows. Here you can see. So right now we will be installing the following one, which would be 5.6.30. So click on download. So now you can see it is asking for an option to download. For that, you just have to click on save file, and the exe file here you can see installer.exe 110 MB will be installed. So here you can see after saving on the left, you can see it is downloading. So as you can see, we have downloaded XAMPP here. So now just click on it. So now you can see the setup for XAMPP is visible. Click on next. Here in back you can see the options are visible, that which component you need to install. Here you can see we have discussed before that it is providing with the Apache server, the MySQL database and other options. So we will keep them as by default. Here you can see PHP admin is visible. Through this we will create a database, that would be our MySQL database for Joomla. After checking the options, click on next. Here you can see it is asking for a folder location. Here you need to add a folder location, add a location, and after adding a location, click on next. So now you can see we clicked on next, and here it is asking for that, do you want to learn more about Bitnami for XAMPP? So click on it, but right now we don't need it, so uncheck it. After unchecking, click on next. Here you can see the setup is now ready to begin installing XAMPP on your computer, that is our Windows machine. Click on next. Here you can see it is installing. Right now it is unpacking files for installation of XAMPP on our Windows machine. So here you can see a XAMPP has been installed correctly. Here it is asking, do you want to start the control panel now? So we need to start the control panel to start our MySQL as well as Apache web server. So we will check it, and after doing the changes, click on finish. Now you can see it is asking for language. Here you can see the language options. We will keep it as default only and click on save. Now you can see it has started the XAMPP control panel. Here you can see the options are visible, which was also visible while we were installing XAMPP. Apache and MySQL. Apache is our web server, MySQL would be our database. So for that we need to first start it. So click on start. So now you can see status chain detected running. It means our Apache is running now. Now I'll select start for MySQL. So now you can see attempting to start MySQL app, status change detected. That means it is running successfully. So now we will see that we have successfully worked upon XAMPP, we have installed it. So now we will see how we can see your XAMPP on basically on localhost by going to the browser. Through that we will go to phmyadmin also and create a database. So let's see it. So we installed XAMPP successfully. So now we'll go to browser and click on localhost. On pressing enter, here you can see XAMPP is visible. If this section is visible after going for localhost and pressing enter, it means you have successfully installed XAMPP. Here you can learn about it. On the left, you can see some options are visible. How to guide FAQs and PHP info, phmyadmin. phmyadmin is basically an application through which you can easily create a database. So click on it. So now you can see on clicking on it, the options are visible, the phmadmin is visible, and the databases, the default databases provided by XAMPP is visible. So here we will create a new database for our Joomla website. So let's create it, click on new. Here you can see on clicking new, some options are visible. Here we need to add a database name and click on go so that we can create a database name. Add a database name, and on the left you can see you just have to click on create. After clicking create, the database would be visible here and it will be also visible here. So let's add a database name here. So here you can see I have added a database name, that is MyDB. After adding the database name, after doing the changes, click on create. Now you can see on clicking create, the database has been successfully created. Here you can see database MyDB, it is visible under the left option. All the databases are visible here. Here you can see right now there are no tables because we haven't linked it with our database right now. We haven't linked our database MyDB with the Joomla installation. So now you can see we have created a database right now. So now we will go to joomla.org and basically download Joomla and then install it. After installation, while installation, we will link it with a database. So let's do it. For downloading Joomla, you just have to go to the website download.joomla.org and press enter. Here you can see the packages are visible. On the left, you can see download Joomla 3.6.5, which is the current version of Joomla. You just have to click on download here. Click here. So here you can see a dialog box is visible where the full package of Joomla is visible, Joomla 3.6.5, which is the current version. It will download the zip version. So click on OK. That would be saving the file, zip file. On clicking OK, on the left you can say it is downloading. It has been downloaded successfully. So now just move this file to a folder, which would be a project folder. So here you can see we will be moving it. Right click on it. Here you can see the options are visible. We need to cut it. We click on cut. So now we will go to a folder and let's see where we will go it. Here you can see we have reached a folder. If you remember, we have downloaded and installed XAMPP in C folder. So go to stdocs under the subdirectory. Then you need to create a new folder. Here we have created a new folder for our project demo web. If you want to create my demo folder, you can create it. Just create a folder. We have created demo web and go under it and paste the zip file. Here you can see. Here you can see the zip file is visible for Joomla. Now we will extract it. Right click on it and click on extract here. Here you can see it is extracting. So now you can see we have successfully extracted our Joomla zip file. So now just delete this file because we don't need it. So now you can see a folder is visible, and under our demo web folder, that is under XAMPP stdocs, we have all the files for our Joomla installation. So now we will go to the browser and type localhost slash the folder name demo web, which is our project folder, and press enter. So let's see what happens. So now you can see we have reached the browser. Here you can see, as I have shown before, type localhost slash demo web. Localhost is our host, which is right now, which that means our website is not uploaded on server right now. We are creating it on our system right now. So localhost slash demo web. Demo web was our folder. After doing the changes, you just have to click on enter. So now you can see Joomla installation has been started. You can check the link, demo web installation. Here you can see the configuration settings are visible first. This is the database. You need to add a database here. But first you can see it is asking for the configuration options. So we'll go to the configuration and add the site name, description, and if you want a site offline or not. So let's just add it. So here you can see we have added the site name. Before that we also selected a language, English by default. If you want to change it, just click a drop down box. If you want some other language, let's say you want Hindi, you can go for Hindi language, or if you want to go for Japanese, you can click on it. By default we are going for English right now. Here I have added a site name which would be visible on the site. You can add any name and you can change from these settings afterward also. Here is a description. Here you can see this is the meta description you can consider that will be visible for search engines. We have added a default right now. You can add any description according to your website. Here you can see the site offline option is visible. If you will click on yes, after installing Joomla, it will show the website is under maintenance. So we'll click on no right now. On the left, you can see some admin options are visible. Here is the administrator email. I've added the email ID. Here is the username. Here is the password and here is the confirm password. After doing all the changes, click on next. Here you can click next from bottom also. So click on it. So now you can see after clicking next, the database option is visible. If you remember, we created a database with the name MyDB. So here we will add it. Here is a database type. Right now we will go for the default one, which is MySQL. The host name is localhost, as we are creating a website on localhost only. If you have created a website straight away on server, you need to add the name of your domain here. Here is the username. We need to add a username. Right now we are creating on localhost, so we will add root here. You can also add a password here, but we are creating on localhost, so we will leave it. Database name, we will add MyDB. This is the prefix. Prefix will basically create a prefix for your table names. If you have already created it, you need to change it right now, but we will create a default one, which is correct. The last one is old database process. Here you can see the backup and remove option are visible. If any existing table of the same name is visible, it will create a backup. So right now we'll go for the default options only. So let's add the username and other stuff. So let's add it. So here you can see the database type is MySQLi. We have selected MySQLi because MySQL, we all know it was visible before. MySQLi is the improved version of MySQL. It provides all the features of MySQL. So now we'll select MySQLi. Host name, we have selected localhost. Username is root because we are focusing on localhost right now. Password, we will leave it right now. If you have straight away uploaded your website and server, you need to add a MySQL password here, database password. Here is a database name which we have created before under localhost phmyadmin in the previous steps. Here is a table prefix and the last one is old database process. On the left you can see the next and previous option is visible. So we have done the changes. We will click on next. So now you can see some options are visible. This is the overview option. That would be the finalization step of Joomla installation. Here if you want to install a sample data, you can install it. These are the default option visible. Overview email configuration. If you want the configuration settings to be visible to your email, to be added to your email, that means an email will be sent to you with all the configuration settings. You can click on yes. Here you can see the main configuration right now, which we have done before. The site name, description, site often was no because we don't want it under maintenance right now. Here is the email ID, the administrative username, the password, and the pre-installation checks are also visible. Right now you can see the pre-installation checks are yes right now. On the left you can see the other options are visible, the recommended settings. Above you can see we also added database configuration settings. That was our type. The host name was localhost. Username we added root. Password we left it, we never added it. Database name was at MyDB, which we added on the localhost phmyadmin. Prefix and under old database projects, we went for the default option, which was backup. So now you can see we need to go for the first option, install sample data. So whenever you will install Joomla for the first time, it will ask you for the option sample data. So if you are a beginner, you can go for the sample data. We will go for the sample data right now. We can go for any option, but right now I'll go for default English sample data. Click on it. Here you can see install Joomla with one page and modules like latest article, login form, etc. and other features. So right now we will go for the default one and after doing the changes, here you can check the options also. On the left you can see the install option is visible, so I'll click on install to install Joomla. So here you can see it is installing Joomla. So here you can see we have successfully installed Joomla for the first time. Congratulations, Joomla is now installed. Here you can see, if you remember in the Joomla overview, I have discussed that if you want to add a new language, a native language, any other language other than English, you can easily add it from here only. Don't need to install any kind of extensions or plugins for it. Right now we will keep it as default, which was our English. Here you can see a very important step is, please remember to completely remove the installation folder from the options of your stdocs folder, which we created demo web folder, so that no one can reinstall your website without your access. So if I'll click on remove installation folder, it will remove it. Or I can also go to the folder. Here you can see I have reached the folder. Here is the installation folder which is visible. You just have to delete it. So in this video we learned how we can work upon installation of Joomla. We saw what are the requirements which are visible. We downloaded Xamp and installed it. We created a database with phmyadmin. We also downloaded Joomla and installed it. While installation, we linked it with the database which we created under phmyadmin. So in the upcoming videos, we will be working on how we can reach our website for the first time, how we can work upon the control panel, other options, menus, and how we can create a dynamic website for the first time. Thank you for watching.